Hello. It has been a while since we have vlogged. But the reason I'm here to vlog today is not a very great reason, not a very happy reason. But it turns out that I most likely have caught the disease myself. It is so strange. We started vlogging during the lockdown to document our lockdown. And now I'm here because I want to vlog and I want to document actually getting the disease for which we got the lockdown, which is quite strange. But since I can't really do much, I don't have the energy to do a lot of stuff during the day, but I have a lot of time on my hands, so I've decided that why not take you through, and by you I mean future me as well, because I mean, as bad as it is to have this disease, it is pretty, I don't know what the word is. Iconic is not the right word, because this is not positive, not a positive thing at all, but you know what I'm trying to say, right? It's crazy. I mean, I don't have my result yet, so it could still be negative, but at this point, the result is inconsequential, if that makes sense, because I definitely know slash feel like I have the disease. Because I know I've never felt like this before. I mean, I've had terrible diseases before, but to have this specific feeling, I know it's not just a cold, and I know it's not just a sardi that people might want me to believe to stay positive. And it's fine, I'm not really stressed or anything, touch wood, because it's not that bad right now. But I thought, let's just take this opportunity of having a lot of free time to document one of probably the biggest events of my generation, a fucking pandemic, in which finally a year into it, I have gotten affected. I've stayed safe for a year, which is great, definitely, but here we are. So, I guess I'll just, I don't know how to do this, how to take you through it, but I guess I'll just do a daily diary entry sort of thing, where I'll tell you how my day has been, how I'm feeling, what are the things around me in my life that have changed. I am wearing my earphone so that it catches it perfectly, because I don't have the strength to talk too loudly and I'm going to forget to talk too loudly. But yeah, life is starting to feel a little strange. Not exactly because of me feeling sick or because I'm alone at home, because those two things have happened in the past. But in things like this, so I'll show you. Auntie has been really sweet and just giving me my meals, which I'm very grateful for. And I would totally understand if she said no, but she's the kind of person who is a proper mom, okay? She would not, knowing that someone that she loves is sick, she's not going to not give them food. That would be even more reason for her to give them food. So I know she wouldn't, I wouldn't even be able to suggest that, because she would think I was ridiculous to suggest that I eat only bahar ka khana for 2 weeks while I am sick. So she's giving me food, but she's not going to give me plates, because she'd have to take the plates back, and that's a risk, right, of her taking anything in her house that I've touched. See, these are the weird things, not exactly the sickness in my body, but the way it's going to affect other people, and I don't like that. Luckily, I'm home alone. Aishwarya has gone to Pune for at least a week, but now if the results turn out to be positive, yeah, I'm a little breathless, so I can't talk too much, and my head starts feeling a little lightheaded if I talk too much or I focus on something for too long. So she's gone to Pune, which is great. I have the house to myself. If it turns out to be positive, then she'll just stay there till it gets till my report comes negative again. So in that way, I'm very glad that she lives close by in Pune, because if it was Anisha, she wouldn't just be able to pick up and go to Chennai. She would be able to, she'd have to, I guess. But Aishwarya decided to go to Pune even before I got tested. She was just going home because she had a work from home week. So that's good. Anyway, so auntie is giving me food. So what she does is, auntie puts the food in these reusable, not reusable, sorry, use and throw dabbas.
I'm not very happy about all the waste I'm going to be creating, but I can't care about that right now. I have to care about my neighbor's health. She's like family to me. I have to care about her health and not worry about waste, unfortunately. So she's giving me food in these dabbas. So she's giving me a dal, she's giving me chicken, she's giving me roti in this, and the bhindi. She put all of this in a plastic bag and she kept the bag outside my door on the floor. And she rang my bell and she went inside her house. She was wearing her mask and she just pulled the door behind her safety door and she just looked to make sure that I'm taking my food and stuff. So that's a bit strange, you know. That feels a little, as much as I know that we have to do all of these things to stay safe and be protected and be cautious, it just feels a little, I don't know what the word is, insulting. You know, I feel like this disease is very insulting. It ostracizes you from everybody. Like, people aren't allowed to touch you anymore. They're not allowed to touch the same things that you've touched. She's not allowed to, if she touches my plates that I've touched, she has to soak them and she has to wash her hands, and she can't enter my house anymore. And there's this whole talk of, are we going to tell the neighbors, you know, should they be, and I will tell the neighbors if my result is positive, they deserve to know, and I will not be stepping out at all whatsoever, so there'll be that. I don't want to tell them right now because I don't have my result, so I don't want them to panic or freak out unnecessarily. But yeah, there's so many added layers to this. Like, if it was malaria, who would give a shit? You'd be at home in your room. You wouldn't be isolated. You'd just be at home recovering and your family would take care of you and people would come to see you and give you gifts. But none of that can happen now. You're literally on your own. Nobody's allowed to see you. Nobody's allowed to breathe the air that you breathe. It's crazy. I went to the doctor today and I had to be so conscious that I wasn't standing close to anybody. I even had to go get my blood test done. I had to go to the I had to go to the chemist to get some medicines. And I am the only one that knows that I'm COVID positive. Maybe I am, maybe I'm not. For this vlog, let us assume that we are. Everyone should live like assuming that they are positive so that everyone's cautious about it, right? So yeah, I'm in the chemist and I'm trying so hard not to go close to anybody, not to touch anybody. Nobody knows that I am showing symptoms and that I may have the disease. But there are people around me that don't know, so they're walking close past me and I'm trying my best not to touch them. There was a girl that came into the chemist with her mask down, yelling stuff like, I don't, and she was literally yelling, like she was talking loudly, so her germs are going all over the place. And obviously she doesn't have the disease, so she doesn't give a shit, but if she knew that me, the girl standing right beside her, is showing symptoms, would she still stand there with her mask down? That made me think about all the other times I might have been in a public place, which I must have been like a few days ago, right? Which is why I'm showing symptoms. I must have got it from someone that was standing beside me unknowingly, like just, I don't know, talking or whatever. And I wanted to tell that girl, fucking mask up. What if, I don't know, you touch the table where, I don't know, my germ fell and then you get it because of me. But I couldn't tell her that. I couldn't tell anyone that. Whew. So that was a bit annoyingly scary and risky. But I had to do it. I had to buy my medicines and come home. I mean, it would have been better if someone else went and did these things for me. But at the same time, I'm so glad Aishwarya is not here. Of course, half, 70%, 80% because she's safer at home, obviously. But 20-30% because I really don't want to have that obligation of someone in the house. Firstly, that I'm risking their health. Secondly, that they have to take care of me. I really don't like that. I don't like when I have to put someone in that position without them willingly being there. Like, I wouldn't feel like that with my family, but the flatmate, they're doing it because they have to, you know. Of course, maybe she wants to take care of me and she does care for me. And I would do the same for her. But yeah, I would rather just recover without the stress of putting someone else under duress for me. So that's my thoughts for today in terms of how I'm feeling physically. I feel this heaviness in my whole body. I feel this breathlessness, like I have to, she's told me to do heavy breathing. In a sense, she's told me to take deep breaths in and deep breaths out. Maybe he hasn't finished his food. But yeah, I feel heaviness in my body. I can't stand and do or walk around much and stuff. Like I went to get my test today and it was so tiring to go and come back. Even standing in the chemist waiting for my turn to come, I almost felt like I really wanted to sit down. So I'm really tired, I'm really weak. I'm not extremely tired, extremely weak, you know, it's not like severe, it's not critical. I don't have to be on bed rest the whole time. I don't need someone to bring me my food to my bed and stuff like that. It's not like that, not at all. It's just, I can't be active for too long. I can't exert myself. So it's, I need to keep laying down, keep sitting down, keep resting, not focus on, like, if I try to read something for too long, then it starts getting to me. So I have to keep taking breaks. I rest, I lie down a lot, I sleep a lot. But that's about it. I cannot smell anything, like, at all, not even in the slightest. Like, I have a perfume that I really don't like because of how pungent, if that's the word, is. It is. Like, it's a very strong smell and I hate strong smelling stuff because anyway, my nose is really sensitive to smell, right? Because of my sinus and my allergies and stuff. And that day I sprayed that perfume, like a lot of it on my hand. I couldn't smell shit. Like I couldn't smell, I wouldn't be able to tell the faintest what that was on my hand. It could have been anything. It smelled like, I don't know, it smelled like water. And it's so funny, all these days I've been thinking, wow, Timiki's litter hasn't been smelling. Maybe this litter is actually good. And you know, I've been cleaning it regularly, so maybe that's why it's not smelling. And yesterday I realized it's because I can't smell anything. It's, this house is probably stinking because of his litter. Because I hadn't cleaned it in a couple of days thinking, wow, it's not smelling, so I don't need to clean it yet. But the house is probably stinking. So yeah, I need to just trust, not go by my smell anymore and just realize, okay, it's been 2 days, I need to clean his litter whether I can smell it or not. And basically stuff like that. My taste has also been impaired. Because of my smell. It's not that I can't taste stuff, I can, but I can only taste the base level of things. Like, I have my chas here, and I drink this chas very often, so I know the taste, I know exactly what it tastes like. But when I drink it now, all I can taste is that it's salty. That's the base level taste of what it is. Before, when I used to drink it, I could taste like some yogurt in it. Like there are pieces, small pieces of yogurt, so I can taste that there's yogurt. I can taste like pepper, or I can taste those different kinds of spices that they use, dhania and stuff like that. But I can't taste any of that anymore. So I feel the part of the taste which is related to your nose, because half your taste buds are also affected by the way you smell it. Like if you close your nose and eat stuff, they say that you might not be able to taste that well. So that's what's happening. Not able to taste that well. Luckily, it's not completely gone, or I don't know. It would be so difficult to eat stuff without tasting them. But yeah, that's how it's been. Otherwise, it's okay. My heart is beating very fast, and the dog said that might. That's one of the whatever symptoms. Then I read online, your heart beats fast when you're sick because your heart is trying to pump more blood and try to fight off the virus or bacteria that's attacking my white blood cells or whatever. I don't know, but you know, that's what it means. Basically, your heart is trying to pump more blood to fight the disease. So that's what's happening. So thank you, heart, for taking care of me. I'm so amazed by the human body that it just fights to take care of itself, you know. In that way, it's not a machine. It's so much more powerful and beautiful than a machine. It's like an automatic, I don't know, it's magic. I love the human body. Okay, I think that's about it for now. I'm getting tired. I want to eat this food and just go and plank on my bed. I want to finish reading the book that I've been trying to read, the Agatha Christie one that Nattu gave me. I'm a little excited by the prospect of this having a lot of free time. But I really want the result to come soon so I can officially take steps to whatever, you know, like tell people, like I want to tell my workplace that I've tested positive, so yeah, that's what it is. I'm not going to be able to work that much, and I still want to work. There are things that I need to do, which thankfully I'm not that bad, so I can do. I want to be able to tell the neighbors, tell my friends and stuff like that. I've told most of my friends already, but yeah, I just, having that test result would just confirm things, you know, and I'd be able to single-mindedly direct all my attention to that. Right now it's still a yes and no, so it's a little annoying, but my doctor definitely thinks it's positive, so we have to behave, we have to believe and behave like it is to be safe. So yeah, I'm going to document my journey through this disease. Hopefully it will be it will be a good journal, a good chronicle of this pandemic a few years later when I'm going through it. Touch wood, I don't infect anyone else. Touch wood, I don't get affected too badly by it, and I'm strong and young and I can recover well. Just hoping. I hate that this happened to me because I was the one that was wearing the mask in my office. I was the only person in my entire office that was wearing a mask. And that day only, the last day that I went to work, everyone was talking about how COVID is just, it's not as serious, and even if you get it, you'll recover. And okay, maybe that's true, but they were all being so against a lockdown. And look, if it wasn't for a lockdown, more people would be in the position that people like me and people like other people that have been tested positive are in. So whatever, man, it's just stupid. But maybe this will set this precedent for them, that I wasn't just being stupid by taking this seriously, and it was good that I took it seriously and I was wearing my mask. I know I still got infected, but who knows, if I wasn't wearing my mask, maybe I would have got infected by someone that had it way worse and gotten worse symptoms. Maybe it's just a mild thing right now that I have because I was being safe. But I don't know what I'm saying anymore. I'm gonna put it off and leave. I am so glad Timothy is with me. I will talk more on him and do a vlog with him next time, maybe. Or any one of the next exciting 14 days to come. Actually, I developed a cold on Sunday night. Today is Friday night. So that was 5 days ago. On that night, I was in Karjat with my family. So if that was the first day that I started showing symptoms, 5 days have gone already. And that's not even the worst part. The worst part is that I was with my parents on that day, which means that they could possibly be affected. They've taken the first dose of the vaccine, and I have told them to go and get themselves tested if they notice even a single symptom, and not to wait. But I don't know, man. They're fucking misers. They're not gonna get tested themselves because they don't want to pay the money to get tested. In fact, I had a very big fight with her today, with my mom, because she called up and, without even inquiring about how I'm feeling, she was asking me how much the test was for, and then she was like, why do you pay so much for the test? I don't even want to go over it again. It pissed me off so much. We had such a bad fight. I just slammed the phone. Like, as if the COVID test ka cost is in my hands, yeah. I'm supposed to sit and get myself tested, or I'm supposed to sit and compare test prices of like 10 different competitors, and then I call all of them and ask them which ones are cheaper to save $150. This is the behavior that I have hated since the very beginning, and I'm so glad I haven't turned out like them. Of course, I am careful with my money, and I am frugal when I have to be, but not when my health is in question, and not when things are important. Like, I'm not gonna sit and try to save $250 to get a test and then risk getting the report later because whatever, they were cheaper or whatever. No, you don't do that shit. What annoys me the most is that they talk like that as if they are spending on my test when they are not.
they make me spend on their test. So how dare you ask me how much I'm spending on my test? And act like it affects you. It doesn't affect you. It's so offensive that you pretend like my expenses have anything to do with you. Like, fuck you, no. I'm not going to explain my expenses to you. You contribute nothing, not a single penny to my expenses. If I want to spend 1,000 bucks on my COVID test or 4,000 bucks on my COVID test, it's my business. I'm not going to talk to her. If she makes the first move to talk to me, sure. Otherwise, I'm fine. Not putting up with this bullshit. And even if she shows symptoms and they act miserly to get tested and don't want to spend, fuck it. Don't get tested. I don't give a shit. I'm not going to mollycoddle these idiots who don't know how to take care of themselves. I have enough and more to worry about in my own life. I can barely taste anything, but I'm hungry. Luckily, I still have an appetite, so I keep eating anyway. But I can't really taste much of this. It's okay, I guess. I'm lucky to get home cooked food. Goldie came in when I was getting my food, and I tried to send her out, and she fucking scratched me. Bitch. Okay. This has become a long video. I'm gonna end it now. I will update you tomorrow.